We're going to have a look at an undervoltage protection module working with an overvoltage protection module. The reason why we have these working together is to protect the battery from both overvoltage and undervoltage. I thought I'd use a real life application to demonstrate these modules. And what I've got is a load that is a small solar pump, 5 watts. I've got a solar panel coming into my system, and I've got a supercapacitor instead of a battery, just so that you can see the increase and decrease in voltages much faster because there's so little capacity in it. So the overvoltage protection module is an YX-1708, and the undervoltage protection module is an YX-1708 and XY-L30A. I've been really pleased with these modules, and I think they work really well. I've got the load going at the moment. This switch is on at about 12 volts and off at about 11 volts. This overvoltage protection module switches on at about 12.7, off at 12.7, and on at 11.6. So it's the pump is consuming pretty similar energy to what the solar panel is providing. Obviously, you could use a charger instead, but I've connected up the solar panel to demonstrate the system, and it's running fairly stable at the moment. Let's look at how I set it up. This module here, the YX-1708, has a solar panel coming. The negative goes straight to the battery, and the positive I've got connected up to this first terminal here. This is the switch. So this switch here runs from a relay that switches it on so that it flows through there, or off so that it breaks it. So when it's on, you're flowing through to the positive connection of the battery. You have to also connect the YX-1708 to the positive and the negative of the battery here. The undervoltage protection module, the YX-1708, has an in where it's connected to the battery. So it just switched off at 11 volts. So what will happen is that the battery will charge, the increase in voltage will occur a lot more rapidly now that the load is switched off. So I didn't want my load to run below 11 volts because not only is it bad for the battery, but because it's a pump and I want to run it at a certain head, once it gets below 11 volts, it doesn't pump that head, so you're just wasting energy. So at about 12 volts, this will switch back on again. And away it goes. And let's see whether the solar panel is actually charging the battery more than what the solar what the pump is consuming. It's actually quite stable. Very little happening there. So let's simulate the example where the solar panel is putting in more than what the pump is consuming, because then you can get over voltage happening. So we'll disconnect the pump, and we'll see the voltage increase. Even though this load is on, the voltage is increasing because we have more coming in from the panel than what we're using. And at 12.7 volts, this will switch the panel off. It'll disconnect the panel from the battery when that light goes off. There you go, and the voltage isn't increasing. Let's connect the pump back on. And what we'll do is we'll actually disconnect this. Oh, the solar panel's already disconnected because it's disconnected through this relay. And so what's happening is that the pump is reducing the voltage on the battery. And 11.6 volts, this will switch back on again. And so now the solar panel is connected to the battery again. And the system is running fairly well. So this is quite a successful method of looking after your battery if you have a solar panel connected to it and you're running a load as well. That's it. So thank you very much for watching.